Let's start with Zelensky's visit to the United States. The head of state to speak at the UN General Assembly. So, I want to ask you, what can this visit bring us? I don't think he will bring us anything breakthrough because I understand the logic of Biden's behavior and his team. We heard Sullivan at the Yalta summit, as well as Biden's statement that the most important thing for him now is Kamala Harris' victory. You've paid a lot of attention to the attempted assassination attempt on Trump, and it's clear that this is causing a lot of problems and challenges for those organizing the campaign.
Зрозуміло, що Байден і його адміністрація, його там Салівани, вони будуть намагатися.
The Biden administration, including Sullivan, is likely to avoid decisions on long-range missile authorization, 300 to 500 kilometers. They won't make public statements, prioritizing election victory, with major decisions left to the next administration.
500 кілометрів. Ну, попри все, ми знаємо, про що ми говоримо, що вони не будуть робити таких публічних заяв, їм важливо виграти вибори, і тільки наступна адміністрація буде приймати якісь принципові рішення. Але
from the point of view of the information campaign, the opportunity to visit the UN General Assembly is always a chance not only to meet with the US president, but also to hold bilateral meetings. Our administration, the Zelensky team, is actively campaigning, announcing in advance the presentation of Ukraine's victory plan.
Кампанію анонсуючи наперед про те, що буде показаний цей план.
Many of your colleagues are asking a fair question. Why don't Ukrainians know everything about this plan? But it is clear that after it is presented not only to Democrats, but also to Republicans, Kamala Harris and Donald Trump, it will become a public document. Then we will be able to analyze it and find out what is new for us in this regard. This criticism or these accusations are objective in that they say that the Ukrainian government is not discussing the so-called peace plan or the victory plan with Ukrainian society. Is it possible to bring such issues to the public in times of war? What do you think? Of course not. But this is also true of the information campaign. But again, there are certain, well, there are certain pillars on which publicity rests. And for any leader of a country, it is very important that society understands and supports him or her. External support is important, but internal support should still be decisive. Therefore, it is necessary to balance this skillfully, as we are still seeing publications that always give out sensational insights. We are wondering what Bild has written this time. Last time they printed maps with the exact directions of attacks, which we laughed and mocked, but maybe now they're telling the truth again. The closer we get to the fall and the possible fall-winter campaign of the war in Ukraine, where the stakes are very high, the more such fake news and information we will see. Ukraine continues, especially Zelensky, to talk about the second stage of the peace summit, which will be attended by Russia. I have no idea in what capacity Russia will be there, who will represent it, and what it will do there, but it is already being talked about as if it were a fait accompli. The role of India, a serious player that has so far been somewhat in the shadow of China and Brazil, is becoming more active. A lot of events are accumulating for this fall, so Ukrainians should understand a certain logic, but we have learned from last year's campaign. And we understand that even if we present classified information to our Western partners, in 2 days, as President Zelensky has already said, it will end up on the table in Moscow, as happened with our counteroffensive plan last year. The Kurdish operation showed that when you narrow the number of people who know the details of military plans, our operations become much more effective.
До мінімуму звузуєш кількість
I will return to the second peace summit to discuss it and India's role in more detail.
Я ще до другого саміту миру повернусь, щоб детальніше про це поговорити і роль Індії тим паче. Але от завершуючи з публікацією
Білого дому, however, concluding the topic, Bilt reports that the peace or victory plan allegedly includes a demand to allow strikes by Western long-range weapons deep into Russian territory. They also talk about the readiness of the Ukrainian authorities to freeze hostilities in certain areas of the front, i.e. a localized freeze. The president's office denied this information, but how plausible do you think it is? You see, you and I did not know about those negotiations. Whether it was Oman or Sudan, or for example Qatar, where certain agreements were made, we would not attack Russian oil refineries, and they would stop attacking our energy facilities. Experts say that even during World War II, certain agreements existed. For example, Germany was advised not to use certain types of weapons, such as napalm, because half of Germany would be incinerated in response. That is, even with Nazi Germany, there were agreements that both sides adhered to.
Порадили не використовувати певні види зброї, напалм, яким вона там мала і яким вона могла використати, тому що у відповідь там буде випалена половина Німеччини. Тобто навіть з нацистською Німеччиною були домовленості, які обидві сторони дотримували. Тобто це не є щось таким незвичним, коли країни, які...
It's not unusual for countries at war to agree on certain things anyway, but it's not public. And here we have a situation that is even more complicated than it was in the world with Hitler, because Putin is just a pathological liar, and his words are worthless.
Його слова нічого не варті. Я розумію, що там не з Путіним домовлялися, але взагалі у Росії така репутація, що домовленості з нею реально нічого не вартують. Це без перебільшення. Тому можуть бути різні форми консультацій, але...
I understand that we did not negotiate with Putin, but in general, Russia's reputation is such that agreements with it are worthless. Therefore, there may be different forms of consultations, but when we talk about a freeze or a pause or a temporary recognition of realities, a global question arises. The key word here is temporary, and this does not give any guarantee that the aggression in Ukraine will not be repeated. The Ukrainian leadership needs to explain to Ukrainians, voters, and the armed forces why they believe an agreement with the aggressor is possible. This would allow the aggressor to regroup and strike again. Wentz's comment on Trump's plan, which seems like a surrender, highlights a lack of concern for Ukraine and his clear position on the issue. He is a modern, cynical politician who has changed his position several times. But now he is the vice president, and he is considered one of the worst candidates for this position. He reveals certain things, and Trump, who distances himself from the 2025 program in the debates, does not give his own assessment of the information coming from his environment. This is also a tactic. However, it is clear that when they repeat how Trump's team sees negotiations, call one, call the other, and build negotiations on that, Zelensky has already reacted to this, calling such approaches an attempt to solve everything at the expense of Ukraine. As a politician, Zelensky is well aware that the Ukrainian voters will not forgive him for this. This approach will not find support in Ukraine. Any politician always relies on public opinion, especially in times of war. Therefore, even if Zelensky is pressured, he is well aware that his agreement to such things means nothing, and he will not be able to force Ukraine, the armed forces, and the Ukrainian people to capitulate.
Він не зможе змусити Україну, українські збройні сили, український народ капітулювати. Він ніколи на це не... Тобто українці на це ніколи не підуть, навіть якщо...
Ukrainians will never go for this, even if Zelensky himself or his advisors look for a rationale in it. And the West understands this. For those unaware, we previously mentioned that a peace plan might involve a demilitarized zone along the Russia-Ukraine line. According to Vance's logic, this zone should extend beyond 100 kilometers. Which is a safeguard against Russia invading Ukraine again. Instead, Ukraine should remain neutral and not join NATO. As you said, these statements outraged many people. I also want to talk about an article in Politico that said today that this winter could be a turning point for Ukraine in a negative sense, and that Ukraine could lose the so-called energy war. Our energy system, according to their forecasts, could suffer a serious collapse. And this negative scenario, as they suggest, could push the Biden administration to decide to transfer long-range weapons to us, as well as to allow us to use these weapons on Russian territory. Given your understanding of American politics, can the argument about the potential collapse of the Ukrainian energy system convince Biden to finally make such a long-awaited decision, despite the risks of possible escalation? I think that these childhood traumas of Biden, who was formed as a politician in the Cold War, remain incurable. I don't think there is any argument that Biden, his advisor Sullivan, and his entire team are consistently afraid of a decisive Ukrainian victory. It's so obvious that they sometimes can't even find the right words. That's why we are likely to see metered aid again.
Вони просто іноді не можуть знайти навіть слова. Тому, скоріше за все, ми можемо очікувати знову оту дозоване надання допомоги. Зверніть увагу, що там...
Please note that there are now about 2 weeks left before the opportunity to allocate more than $6 billion from the aid package expires. What prevented the Biden administration from giving us this money earlier? Why did they only allocate tranches of $250 million? They had a decision from Congress. They understood everything perfectly well.
У мене немає ілюзій стосовно того, що Байден на фінішній прямій свого президентства зможе побороти оці свої...
They had the opportunity to use the Lend-Lease program. In short, I have no illusions that Biden will be able to overcome these internal fears and the Cold War worldview at the end of his presidency. Rational logic will not win here.
Про те, що от якщо... Росіяни там роблять ось це, якщо там Північна Корея там вже завалила просто Росію зброєю, а і Китай вже починає давати зброю, і я не знаю, що може там...
Russia is doing one thing. North Korea is flooding Russia with weapons. China is starting to provide support, and I don't know what else has to happen for the Biden administration to finally change its approach. Perhaps Trump is thinking in different terms. He says that if Putin resists, he will pull out all the stops. This is his style. Trump is unpredictable, and he can act like an alpha male competing with another alpha male. But what if Putin doesn't take his call? What will Trump do then? It is much harder to predict Biden in such a situation. Unfortunately, this will again be done in doses. I don't know if we will be able to get these $6 billion. And why didn't this happen in June, when we had to adopt a plan for Ukraine's victory? The war has been going on for 3 years now, and Biden continues to provide abstract assistance. The Republicans are scoring political points on this. Why wasn't a decision made in June, and now September is coming to an end, and there are still no results? I just don't believe, analyzing the style of the Biden administration and the Democrats, that there will be anything new. However, there is hope that the other Democrats in Kamala Harris's team can act more firmly. I have heard that their approach to foreign policy is much more decisive. In summary, I don't have much hope that the Biden team will change its policy.
Підсумовуючи, ні, в мене немає особливих надій на те, що команда Байдена зробить якісь кроки, які будуть принципово відрізнятися від їх,
which has not undergone any major changes over the last 3 or 5 years of their rule. But it seems that the Ukrainian authorities still hope for this. Zelensky gave an interview to CNN and said that he plans to present his victory plan to Joseph Biden there. This plan should definitely contain information about the creation of a buffer zone and permission to strike deep into Russian territory. However, it seems that the United States is not particularly enthusiastic about such steps, at least judging by the statements you partially mentioned. Do you think that the meeting between Biden and Zelensky, if it takes place next week, can be fruitful?
Плодотворною зустріч Байдена і Зеленського, якщо вона зрештою відбудеться ось уже наступного тижня?
It will take place, but it will not be what we can call a fundamental breakthrough. It is important to understand that we will hear assurances that the United States has been, is, and will be with Ukraine. But practical questions will remain unanswered. For Zelensky, it is important to show that the United States is our partner, and for Biden, it is important to show that he supports Ukraine. It is worth noting that Kamala Harris launched a series of videos after the debate in which she clearly positioned herself as a leader who supports Ukraine. As opposed to Trump and Vance, for whom Ukraine is irrelevant and Trump is a friend of Putin. Thus, the issue of Ukraine has already been included in the presidential campaign, and they cannot publicly admit that they will reduce their support for Ukraine. However, when it comes to fundamental changes or certain expectations, Biden has only a few months left. How much can we talk about the threat of escalation? However, he still does not dare, and I'm sure he will not dare. Unfortunately, we have to wrap up, but thank you very much for joining us today. Thank you, friends. Ole Rybakhuk was on the line with us, the head of the analytical and advocacy organization Center for Joint Action.
Друзі, Олег Рибачук був з нами на зв'язку. Це, власне, голова аналітично-адвокаційної організації «Центр спільних дій».